Thank you.
Thank you. senior night. Our pregame ceremony, which honors our senior athletes, will begin following the conclusion of tonight's CAB contest, so stick around. Thank you.
Help! Thank you.
Just a reminder, our senior medal ceremony will be here shortly. Our exciting senior night, we have the cheerleaders.
Madison Lewis is the daughter of Maggie Winnell and Matthew Lewis. Her future plans are to go to college and study business. She is thankful for Coach Peck for being there for the person she was five and teaching her everything she knows about the sport. She is also thankful for Coach Chloe for everything she has taught her. She is thankful for Coach Kip for helping her make her laugh, and she is not thankful for dating a son. Lastly, she is thankful for her mom and dad for pushing her to do her best for, to be her best version of herself and making her try her words. She wouldn't be where she is today without them. Her favorite memory is of the bus ride with Coach Chloe, if you know, you know. And every time I have fallen on her and made her a bloody nose for taking her out on the way down. Her advice to the team is to take advantage of the moments you have left, savor every moment you have left because it goes by fast.
Next up, the Mustang community would like to recognize the following South Seneca seniors. Her senior is Jaden Reed. And then we have AJ Denmark. And lastly, Owen Kenyon. Next, the Mustangs would like to reintroduce the team, and we ask the underclassmen parents to come down to the basketball court to accompany their son. First off, we have 11th grader Eben Foster, 11th grader Matthew Jones, 11th grader Logan Miller, 11th grader Anthony Cadella, and 11th grader Ethan McWhorter. If they have my parents joined up on the basketball court. Starting off, the seniors, we have number 32, Uriah Davis Falter. Uriah is here with Joelle Davis and Jeff Falter. This is his first year on the varsity basketball team. Uriah's favorite memory is when Matt hit the game winner. The first time this season, the entire team being played together was a feeling that was unmatched. Ray would like to say thank you to his parents for supporting him all the way, to Coach Joel for being there when he needed him, and for helping him learn how to work with the team, and also for the team being so supportive because they're some of the funniest people he's ever been around. Ray will attend a temple in Tokyo to study Japanese language next fall. Coach Jordan would like to thank Gray for his selfless attitude and his hard work every time he entered the gym. His team first attitude was top on the team. That's Gray Davis Halter. Next up, we have number 12, Jackson Venus. Jackson Venus is here with Brian Ashley Lewis. Jackson has been a part of the Mustangs basketball program since the 7th grade. Jackson's favorite memories of basketball are beating Seneca Falls last year in sectionals and Matt's buzzer beater game winner the other night while in the Honeyway. Jackson wants to thank Coach Doyle, Coach Emerson, Coach G, and his teammates. He appreciates all the things his coaches and teammates have done for him and how they push him to be the best version of himself. Jackson will be going to a trade school for electrical work and he plans to own his own electrical business someday. Coach Doyle will certainly miss Jackson's fiery attitude next season and never gets pushed around style of the play for. That's Jackson Enos. Number 15, Liam Chapman. Liam is here with Heather and Michael Chapman. This is Liam's second year in the varsity program. Liam is a member of the Mustangs baseball program, where last year he earned first team all league in the sectional final, co-MVP. Liam's favorite memories were the team's dinners at Coach Doyle's house. Liam wants to thank Mr. McKercher for his support, Coach Doyle and his family for the dinners, and to Coach Emerson for shooting one-on-one with him. Jackson wants to thank his parents for everything they've done for him during the basketball season. Coach Doyle will remember listening to Coach Brown to talk a undecided Liam into playing his freshman year. Liam's ability to get the easiest spot in any drill, but first spot in any buffet line will be something he will never forget. Next year, Liam will attend SUNY Brockport to play baseball. He will study business. And that's Liam Chapman. And those are our seniors for this year.